We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Washington Nationals and the Philadelphia Phillies. It's Phillies Baseball next on the show. Zach Wheeler is ready to go as he's on the mound for the Phillies. Dan, please, Zach, what's the word on him?
This guy's a pretty good pitcher, and I was looking through his stats, and one thing jumped out at me, a sub 1.20 whip coming into this start. That tells me a couple of things. One, he's not afraid to throw strikes, and two, when he does throw strikes, he throws quality, and he still gets people out. It'll be fun to watch this guy work in this one today.
Here now is Trey Turner, and we are set for baseball here this evening. And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. These Phillies, as they enter play here tonight, fellas, they're definitely in a nice stretch as they've won 6 of their last 7 ball games.
Yeah, Matty B. Hey, D-Row, we're looking at a team playing some pretty good baseball right now. Through the first 5 games of this homestand, 4-1, and looking for some bigger and better things.
Yeah, we had a chance to sit down before the game after BP with the manager. He was really pleased with the way his team has played in these last 5. Let's see if it continues today.
There's no question he's been struggling at the dish, trying to do anything to get himself going. So he's got to feel pretty good after that double. Not to take anything away from him, but I think I could have probably hit that pitch.
Yeah, that's one of those gift pitches, not the location he was shooting for. Adam Eaton digging in next. Yep, the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. The 1-0 fouled away. Here's Wheeler on 1-1.
Nope, at the ball.
Close there, but he doesn't get the call with the breaking ball. And set up behind the plate is Kenny Jansen, as you see the rest of the umpiring crew there.
Hey, the book on Kenny Jansen, D-Row, not a very big zone, but he will give you that low pitch below the knees.
Yeah, and he's consistent. You're okay with that as an offensive player. He wants to give that pitch below the knees. If this pitcher can execute consistently, you better make the adjustment.
Here now the 2-2. And this is popped up. Back behind second. Here for it is Segura to make the play. One gone.
Batting third, the left fielder, number 22, Juan.
Here now is Juan Soto, and he'll be looking to snap out of it in this one. Not having much success at the plate over the last week and a half. He's set. Here it comes. And that swung on and missed for strike one.
Well, he kind of tipped his hand right there. His approach is obviously sitting on the off speed because he was so late on that first pitch either.
Hey. Strike two. That misses 1-2.
Love the high heater right there to raise the hitter's sights. Let's see if he buries something in the dirt right here.
Turner leads off second with one gone in the inning. Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll send it on to first, and that will freeze the runner at second with two away now.
Well executed two-seamer on the outside corner. That right. And that's what you'll get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over.
So next will be the 4-hole for the Nationals. Jeremy De La Rosa. And with numbers like those, he's putting himself in contention for some Rookie of the Year hardware if he can keep it up. Here comes the first pitch. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that'll get down out there near the wall. He pulls into second safely as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play.
This is why it's so important to give your cleanup hitter an opportunity to hit with runners in scoring position. He does just what he's supposed to do, lacing a double and driving in a run, just like you draw it up.
Now batting, Starlin Castro. And as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. From the stretch. Below the knees, one ball, no strikes. His career line against Wheeler, just a 2-for-14 line, so advantage pitcher here. He's also gone down on strikes 9 times. Fly ball out to straightaway right field. Harper has a read on it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. One for the Nationals on the RBI double. On to the bottom of the first, and Washington has the early 1-0 lead. Eric Fetty gets the starting assignment for the Nats in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, in a day and age where we don't see very many complete games, 6 really good innings in his last start to pick up the win, and I think they'll be happy if he can duplicate that again in this one.
Gene Segura standing in. We'll take a look there at the difference in his numbers between June and July. Delivery to him on the way. So guys, these Nationals, as they interplay here tonight, despite the loss last time out, they've won 4 in a row, so they've been on a nice little roll here.
Yeah, Matty, this is a team that, if you look at the standings, you would say they haven't executed all year. But you know what? Today's a different day. They're playing good baseball right now, clicking on all cylinders, and a team that's scary. You don't want to play these kind of teams when you're fighting to get to the postseason.
Tight with that one. 3-0.
Well, he knows it, but this is the kind of guy you just have to go right after. He's not the biggest threat with the bat, so it's time to challenge him right here.
Here it is, the 3-0. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball 4.
Well, there's only a 1-run cushion to play with, so he's got to be upset after he walked the leadoff man here. Go-ahead run comes to the plate, and there are no outs. This could be a very interesting inning.
Striding forward for his first chance, Justin Turner. And the confidence might be wavering at the moment. Last 10 or so ball games have been a real struggle for him. Set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Grounded down the third baseline. And that's a fair ball as this one gets by him at third.
Something you don't see very often. You got a guy that can run at first base. Normally you'll see a hitter trying to take a pitch or 2-0 to give that guy a chance to steal a bag.
You know, it's funny you say that, Dan, because coming up in those situations, you want to give the guy a chance. But you also realize that that guy wants to give his catcher a chance, so you're probably getting a piece of cheese.
So now to the plate, Mark Withenshaw. So take a look at a slider that can't make it back to the corner. It's ball 1. So far this season, with runners in scoring position, Withenshaw is hitting over .350, up in the high 300s.
You want to talk about having a career season, Matty. This guy's batting average is through the roof, one of the best in the business. And maybe more importantly, his OPS is through the roof as well, which means he's doing it with damage.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With 2 guys already on, a pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Two and one after the foul ball there. Holland behind the mound, 3-1.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. You elevate a little bit more and get back in the zone, or you just pitch around it.
And he fouls this one off. First baseman. Bases loaded here, nobody out. And it's fouled away. Needs a punch out here. Can he get it? First inning even better here. From the stretch.
Ball one.
Well, I think he's got to find a way out of this jam and limit the damage. If he's unable to do that, this game could get away from him.
Swung on and chopped down the line at first, but a foul ball, 1-1. From the belt, kicks and deals. That one's down around the knees, taken for a strike.
Hey, as a former infielder, nothing hurts your heart more than making errors behind your pitchers. Let's see if this guy can pick him up right here.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Count still at 1-2. From the stretch. A wild pitch, but the catcher is able to knock it down. And a nice job to keep the runners at bay as the count moves to 2-2. Kicks and deals. A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away.
Wow, that's the case right there where a pitcher knows this guy's up there. He's in swing mode. That pitch wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he still swung it.
In now, Zach Collins. First pitch misses to him. It's ball one.
I think this inning could have far-reaching effects in this game. They're really making him work, and unless he dials it in, it's probably going to limit how deep he goes into this game.
The 1-0. On the ground to the left side. Scooped up. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score.
Grounder was hard hit. Sometimes the runner at third will have to hold on a ball like that, but he was off on contact, and they opted to take the out at first instead.
Settling in now, Logan Forsythe. And you see that average below the dreaded Mendoza line. Set and the pitch. And that's inside for a ball. 1-0.
He definitely doesn't look himself to start this one. And this lineup needs to be on the attack early and be aggressive and find a way to stay in this game.
One and one the count now. The belt kicks and deals.
Two balls, one strike.
On that one. Two balls and a strike. The 2-1 home. Lofted in the air out toward right center. De La Rosa there to put it away and finally put an end to the inning. So they nearly bat around here as eight men come to the plate and they push across four runs. One inning in the books here. Phillies lead this one 4-1. Digging in now, number four. And the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. Here comes the first pitch.
Hey.
Wind up and the 0-1. And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's 1-1.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
1-2.
I can't imagine he was sitting on fastball at his neck right there. He's going to have to lower his sights if he's going to have any chance.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. A ball and two strikes from Zach Wheeler. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes. That elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that. But most of the time, you get the result you saw right there. A big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
Into the box, Tyler Nevin. As He looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. He's back in the starting lineup for this one after sitting out last night's game. Count even at 1-1 to the Nationals first baseman. Pitch on the way. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. To two balls and two strikes now. And swung on and missed. He got him.
On the mound, he's thinking, grab some pine, Rook. Listen, for almost everyone, the adjustment to hitting big league pitching is a big one. Some guys have success when they first get called up, but as soon as teams start figuring out how to get you out, that's when the learning process really starts.
Stepping in now, Sean Murphy. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. Set to deliver the 0-1. Well, he's got him in the palm of his hand now. It's 0-2. And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
Good pitch there on 0-2. Breaking ball out of the zone away. Might set up another breaking ball to see if he'll chase this one a little bit farther off.
Check swing here, but he holds up far too late as it's strike three and the inning is over. Three up, three down for Washington, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Now at the plate, Zach Wheeler set to lead off the home half of the second. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Now a flare out to left center. Turner onto the grass. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
The batter number two, Justin Herrera.
So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in the middle infielder Gene Segura. Delivery to him on the way. On the ground to the right side. That will find its way into right field for a one-out single. They've gotten their hits in deep counts. They've gotten their hits in early counts. This has been a real onslaught.
You can look at it from two ways. They have respect for the men on the mound, and they are just going to ambush tactics, and it seems to work for them. Or you can look at it the other way. They're just going to
first pitch, here it comes. A ball and no strikes. Runners on first with one down. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball. Just manages to get his hand in. Two and oh pitch on the way. Slider gets the outside. That's a strike.
Don't know for sure, but I think he may have been taking there thinking his teammate on first was going to be on the move.
No, he dived, but he's back. 2-1 pitch. Breaking ball called just a bit low.
Well, his last time out, guys were just flailing away at that slider. But tonight, completely different story. I think their approach coming into play tonight was to lay off that pitch until he shows he can throw it for a strike.
From the belt, kicks and deals.
Now it's 3-2.
Ani bailed him out with a swing, 3-2 now.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
Hit in the air down the right field line. Eaton on the move, but no chance to run it down. It's a foul ball. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. De La Rosa there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
The center fielder, 24, Mark Withenshaw.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Mark Withenshaw. He's 2-for-7 in the series so far. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes.
Wow, that's 40 pitches for him already. This doesn't have the makings of a start that he's going to go very deep.
Here's a look over to first. Runner's back. Two out with the man at first. Two and oh to the Philly center fielder.
This is a spot you really don't want to be in with a great hitter like that. You can't just lay one in there, but you also don't want to run the count to 3-0.
The 2-0. That's lifted the other way out to left. Soto will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Phillies strand one, but they lead it 4-1. Top of the third set to get underway, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Eric Fetty.
The pitcher, Eric Fetty.
Here comes the first pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
This lineup is flailing right now. They're having a hard time just making contact, let alone putting the ball in play.
Fouled off. Wind up and the 0-2 pitch. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it 4 strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Boy, he's really on a roll in the hill right now. As we roll through it again, remember, he struck out the side in the last inning, and now he picks up right where he left off by striking off the leadoff man here. Let's see if he can keep this going for a little bit.
In now. Third baseman in tight protecting the bunt, the first pitch. Runs up to bunt here, but he missed it for strike one. A 1-1 count to the Nationals leadoff batter. Line drive to left. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And he is in at second base with a one out double.
You've got to applaud the effort there from the left fielder. It just didn't work out as the ball squirts by him, resulting in a double. That's the danger of leaving your feet in the outfield.
In now is Adam Eaton, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Now a spin and a throwback to second, and he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. One, here's the pitch. Now a breaking ball runs in on him as he's got to get his hands out of the way on that pitch. 4-1's our score here in inning number 3. And that's lifted the other way out to left. Bruce coming on. He can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. And the runner from second will stay put at third, so they're runners at the corners now with one away. Juan Soto to the plate now. Guess he'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Behind the plate. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Two quick strikes and now the 0-2. And this one's inside and high. 1-2 now. Runners are at the corners with one man out. Into the corner and slicing foul.
Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not going to see too many of those today.
The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
Lifted the other way to left center. Bruce giving chase. He can't get to it. This one's down. And to score is the runner from third. It's now a 4-2 game.
Now batting the center fielder.
And now time is called here as their pitching coach is going to pay a quick visit to the mound to discuss how they want to attack things here. Into the box now, Jeremy De La Rosa, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing in one. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate. He's set. Here's the 0-1. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now. First and second now, one man out. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. A swing and he pops him up on the infield, and the infield fly rule will be in effect here.
The batter number 13, second base, Starling Castro.
Here's Starlin Castro. Two on, two out for him here in the third. First offering on its way.
Very rarely does a pitcher like this leave one in a location like that. That's a pitch right there he'd like to have back. He'd love to swing at that one again.
Thank you. Here's the 0-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. On the move is Harper. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. So it's a run on three hits, no errors, and two men left on. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. It's the Phillies 4 and the Nationals 2.
We're back now as the Phillies prepare for their at-bats here in the third inning. And this lineup has been terrific for this club all year. Coming into the day, they are up near the top of the league in home run production. So it's certainly safe to say they're a fun bunch to watch swing the bats. When asked about their success with the long ball, one player told me, "Yeah, home runs are fun and they can change a whole game. So when we get a pitch we can do damage on, you better believe we're looking to launch." Matt, back to you.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks.
Way to go.
Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring up Bryce Harper. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch.
1-0.
Now the 1-0. Drilled down the line, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. Now here's the pitch. Swung on and chopped to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. And that'll bring up the Sacramento product, Reese Hoskins. 0-1 with a run batted in thus far. First pitch on its way. Third inning here, already 4-2 our score. Ground ball sent back up the middle, and that will find its way into center field for a one-out hit.
And from the list of stats you'd never want to hear if you're a pitcher, we have this. It's only the third inning, and he's already allowed more hits than he did in his entire last outing.
Here's Jay Bruce now. As he'll take a look at his sinker here, too low for ball one. 0-1 here in the early going. Ready with the 1-0 now to Bruce. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. He will haul this in on the run as he had to go back to the warning track to do it, and there are two away.
Now batting, catcher, Zach Collins.
Stepping up to the plate, Zach Collins. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. First pitch coming, here it is. And a high strike to begin the at bat. It's 0-1.
Hey, the way this guy on the mound's been struggling to find his zone, I'm not mad at the guy taking a pitch.
Ready with the nothing and one pitch.
Ball. 1-1.
Runner on first with two away.
Stop,
slider just about gets away from him there as it runs in a bit too close for comfort.
Great game plan so far by this offense. They're not chasing any of those breaking balls out of the zone.
Now the 2-1 pitch.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Three, two pitch. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Eaton is under it. And that ends the inning. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. The three of us return with more Wednesday Night Baseball after this. And we're back from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already, and he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Stepping up now, number four comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
And he misses with it, 1-1. Slider up into the 90s there. It's 1-2.
Look at the radar gun on that slider. Off speed pitch, 91 miles an hour. That's just pure filth.
A ball and two strikes from Zach Wheeler. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Oh, man, he's been absolutely getting overmatched at the plate the last couple of games. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone. So clearly this pitching staff, they figured out how to attack this guy. We'll see if he can make any adjustments.
To the plate now, Tyler Nevin. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. He's 0 for 1 thus far. That's inside, 2-0.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
And wow, that looked to be well inside, but it's a called strike. 2-1 now. Now here it comes. It's a fastball on the inner third, taken for a strike. 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. Got him on the good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. Another strikeout for him on the mound. And boy, is it fun to watch him go about his business.
No doubt, Matty. He's one of my favorites, mostly because of his stuff. You know, he can absolutely dominate on any given day because of what he offers up there. It's just nasty. There aren't many hitters that like to see this guy on the mound.
No balls and one strike. And one, here it comes.
I got one ball, one strike.
We're in the fourth inning of a 4-2 ball game. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Wait, that was an ugly swing. I'm sure he's not going to watch that one on replay after the game.
And he struck him out. A 4-2. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with Philadelphia's manager during the break about the Phillies' offensive production to this point. And he was very pleased with how little they're swinging and missing right now. Looking at the advanced data, our researchers found that about 9 of 10 swings are resulting in some sort of contact today, which is well above major league average. The result has been a lot of balls in play, a lot of hits, and solid run production, guys.
Okay, thank you, Heidi.
Waiting on for the Phillies.
Ready now, Logan Forsythe. Set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. First delivery to him on the way.
That's a ball.
That's right. Wait for it.
Well, it's been a rough one so far. Four runs through three innings. It's about time to get that pitch count down, or he won't be out here very long.
Now the 1-0. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike. Two and one.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with the bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty. But, hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
Ground ball left side. Good throw gets him one gun.
Now back, the pitcher. Wheeler.
Now in the box, Zach Wheeler. Flied out in his first at bat, so making 0 for 1 so far. Here's the pitch. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
They've had some good at-bats against him all game long. It seems like it's just been hard hit after hard hit. As we take a look at his line here, the numbers do not lie. This has not been one of his better outings, and he'd be the first to tell you that.
And that'll bring up Gene Segura as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. The 0-1 pitch lays off the sinker here, a ball and a strike. Hits are even right now at five aside. Segura behind on a 1-2 count. The 1-2. It's laid off for ball two.
I'm seeing all the signs of fatigue right now. This is when you really have to bear down mentally as a pitcher.
And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2. This is ball four, so it's first and second now with only one away.
And with first base open, the last thing he wanted to do was give him something to hit in the heart of his own. So no harm done. Force out anywhere now.
On his way out to the mound now, the Washington manager. And he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So a less than stellar performance here tonight as he makes the early exit and forces that bullpen into action much earlier than anticipated. Ryan Harper answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter.
Harper.
Justin Turner will be his first assignment here as he'll face it with runners at first and second and one gone. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Here's a curveball that runs outside. It's ball one.
Looked like he was a little over-aggressive there to throw that nasty curveball. Just needs to slow his delivery down a bit.
Four runs, five hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Ball and a strike.
I got a ball, one strike.
Ties him up with a fastball inside, one and two. Working for the punch out and the offering. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land out there just foul.
He was looking for a swing and a missed breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
And a high chopper. The second for one, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first.
Took a pretty long time for the shortstop to receive the ball that time. So that gave the runner plenty of time to bear down on him and take him out. Hopefully everyone's okay down there.
Into the box now, Mark Withenshaw. And their runners at the corners now. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And, oh, that looked like it caught him squarely in the arm. Fortunately, he's able to stick with it and get the out at first. And that'll put an end to the inning. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and two men left on. We played four full. Philadelphia is on top, 4-2. Into the box now, the Nationals pitcher, Ryan Harper. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How did they get to him here?
I'm not sure, Matt, that they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
First pitch on its way.
Ball one, no strike.
Big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing. Here's Wheeler on one and one. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind one and two.
This hitter right now looks overmatched with a fastball. I think you go right back to it.
Now a ball pulled hard but foul off to the left.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
Heading out towards shallow right. Harper giving chase. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first down.
Now batting. Shortstop. Play. Turner.
One gone for the Nationals in the fifth. And that'll bring up one of the fastest players in all the land, Trey Turner. Here's the first pitch to him. Sends that one out of play for strike one. 4-2 our score here as we play inning number five. And that's the second out.
Good pitch right there to run the two-seamer in on his hands and bunch him up. And an easy ground ball as the result.
Digging in once again, Adam Eaton. He singled his last time up. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
At the ball.
Looking at his career totals, Eaton carries a hitting line just over the 280 plateau. Down the first baseline. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for Washington. Still down by a count of 4-2. The count to Bryce Harper, and now a curveball that bounces up to the plate. It's 1-1. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Waves and misses for strike number two.
1-2.
Still a ball and two strikes. Try again, 1-2.
Four, that's inside.
As he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. Digging in to try it again, Reese Hoskins. It was a single for him in his last at bat. Here's the pitch. There's a strike with the breaking ball. Four runs, five hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. And he falls behind 0-2. Nothing in two count and the pitch. Ball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
That's a pretty unique pitch sequence, guys. Usually pitching is all about mixing pitches and location, but he threw that all out the window to get that strikeout. He offered the same pitch three times in a row, so I guess he sort of used that reverse psychology to outthink his opponent.
At the plate, Jay Bruce. He'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. 0-2 from him so far in this one.
Ball one.
And you look at a fastball just off the black, and it's even at one. Fouled away. bases are empty here with two men out. And a great inning here as he gets another punch out and strikes out the side in order. Three up, three down for Philadelphia as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Digging in and looking for more, Juan Soto. He came through with an RBI single in his last at bat. First pitch on its way. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone. The 1-0. Fastball that misses.
2-0 to a guy with this kind of pop, you better be awfully careful because he's going to be swinging out of his shoes.
Look out. All over the place now. 3-0.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three ball count.
They won't let him walk that easily, as that somehow ruled a strike. 3-1 now. To first, Hoskins has it, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
The center fielder, number one, Jeremy Villarosa.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Jeremy Villarosa. He's ready. Here's the first offering. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. But it bends just foul into the second deck.
Man, he wants that swing back. He'll be thinking about that all night. He crushed that ball. He just needs to stay back a little longer.
In there, and he's ahead 0-2 now.
If he's able to locate that two-seamer down at the knees, he's going to get a ton of swing and miss and a ton of ground balls today.
Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
And there's out number two.
Now that the second baseman, Starling Castro.
So here's Starlin Castro. He hits with two away as they continue to trail in this close game.
Well, Matt, this has been a big inning on the mound. He's had to face the middle of the order, and so far he's held them at bay.
Yeah, this feels like the kind of inning we'll look back on at the end of the game, even if the result of it changes dramatically here. First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
Two balls, one
big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Now the 2-1. Center field. Withenshaw is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Nationals gone in order. They trail it here 4-2. Striding in, Zach Collins. He'll lead things off against the same reliever that finished off the last inning.
Well, you don't see it this day. Too many relievers going multiple innings. The guys have to earn that trust from their managers. We'll see how he handles it here.
Oh. Here's the first pitch to him, and he fouls this one off. Sent on the ground out to second. And the throw by Castro takes care of him for the first down.
The batter, the second baseman, Logan Forsythe.
Ready for another shot now. Logan Forsythe, 0 for 2 for him to this point. He's set. Here it comes. In there, no balls and a strike. Set to deliver the 0-1. Here's a breaking ball outside, and now it's even 1-1. We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. And misses badly. It's ball two. The 2-1. Hot shot down the line. This will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Now here's the pitch.
Full count, 3-2.
One out, nobody on. Soft grounder left side. He's got it. And there are two away now. So here now is the pitcher, Zach Wheeler, hitting in his own turn with his guys up by two in inning number six. First delivery to him on the way. Ready with the nothing and one pitch.
It's down 1-1. Let's go, Phillies. The count is 2-1.
This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Castro's got it. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Phillies down in order, but they still lead this one 4-2. Standing in, number 4. And he's likely just trying to put one in play here. 0-2 with a pair of strikeouts thus far.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop in a glass? They could certainly use that right now.
Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, Matt. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7.
Oh, man, you can't hit a ball any harder than that. I mean, this ball gets on him in a heartbeat. Nice job to stay with it, though, and then make the out at first.
So striding forward now, Tyler Nevin. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Here comes the first pitch. A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Seventh inning here at the ballpark. 4-2 our score. Count remains at 0-2. Now here's the pitch.
I got to count 1-2.
That fastball really got away from him there. That's kind of a red flag for me that he's starting to tire or wear down a little bit. The first thing that goes is location and then your mechanics. We'll see if this continues.
Ball trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
2-2. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Down the third baseline. Throw pulls the first baseman off the bag. And this will go down as an E5, as you can see the exasperation in his face. So it's a runner at first as a result of the throwing error. And next to hit is the catcher, Sean Murphy. First offering on its way.
1-0.
Runner at first here, one man out.
All two.
Just missing here, 2-0.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
2-0 pitch on the way.
3-0.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late. See guys get through the seventh inning, so he's through the sixth here with one out, and Mark DeRosa so far so good, a pretty decent outing.
Yeah, and I think it's going to be batter to batter here for the manager if he's going to continue to ride this hot hand or if he's going to go to the bullpen.
Now the payoff pitch home, soft liner to the left side, and that'll get down for a base hit.
Now's a good time for your pitcher to take a deep breath. He still has the lead, although it probably doesn't feel like it. So he can't worry about how he got into this mess. He just has to figure out how to get out of this mess.
Here comes the Philly skipper on his way out toward the mound. And that is going to be all for Zach Wheeler. So he'll leave with the lead. Can't lose this one, but he is responsible for the two runners out there, so he could get no decision if they were come around. Mike Mora comes on the pitch here with one man gone in the top of the seventh. Victor Robles come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. Comes at him with the slider there, and he gets the strike. Grounder down the line at third. And that'll get fouled. It's 0-2 now.
Boy, the Nationals could use a big hit right here. They really haven't been able to do much all game long. This would be a great time to get something going.
Here it comes, 0-2. Here's a shot to right field, and that's going to be in for a base hit.
third as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away.
Play. Nice piece of hitting right there. Looked like the guy on second had to respect it and freeze a little bit.
They had to freeze there for a second to make sure that line drive gets down, but eventually does get to third base.
So stepping in, Trey Turner, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. From the stretch, popped him up. Under it now is Segura, and he's got it. Two away now.
Wow, talk about frustrating.
Not what you want to do with the bases loaded. A simple pop up, and nothing productive comes out of that.
Digging in,
Adam Eaton.
And with men on base and two away, it feels like this at-bat could go a long way toward deciding this thing.
No doubt, Matt. A base hit here changes this game quite a bit. But if they can't score here, it looks pretty bleak for them heading into the last couple of innings.
First pitch of the at-bat.
Clearly, this is a tough situation to be on the mound, but the key here is minimizing. We're up by two, so if he could find a way to get out of this bases loaded jam by only giving up one run, that would be clutch.
Fastball just inside. Big spot. Two out, possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Yanked on the ground down the line. But this will get fouled. It's a ball and two strikes. Here's a fastball on the fist, and that'll even things up to 2-2. He stays alive, still 2-2. Here it is. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run full now. 3-2.
Well, all of the umpires in the seats thought that was strike three, and they weren't far off, but I think that was a good call. Looked to be just a bit outside.
Lifted the other way to left center. And this gets down. Extra bases, and this could change everything. And the score is the runner from first. It's a 5-4 game.
Dan, you'll take RBIs any way you can get them, but when they give your team the lead in the late innings, man, that feels good.
Oh, especially good. Especially when you start to score runs late in the game off of the quality pitching. When runs are at a premium, that's one that makes you feel really good about yourself.
So now to the plate, Juan Soto. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Bruce has a read on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. So they pick up three runs on three hits, one error, and one man left on. We'll move on now to the bottom half of the seventh. Get up and stretch. Nationals on top, 5-4. Daniel Hudson gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Daniel Hudson.
Seventh here, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Gene Segura.
This thing's far from over, and even though we're moving into the back end of this game, only down by one, all they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Eaton is under it. One away.
Now batting, the third baseman,
Justin Turner.
Now at the plate, Justin Turner. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Hudson comes at hitters with a good hard fastball, one that's certainly fun to watch.
He's a throwback, the kind of guys that he likes his fastball. It's a good fastball, not the best fastball in the game, and he's not afraid to throw it. And you know what else, Matty B? He goes right at the hitters.
Pulled the fastball down a little too much there. That's ball one. Bases are empty, one man. Stride that time, and it's one and two.
Real ugly 0-1 swing there. As a pitcher, you've got to be hunting for the strikeout, knowing you have this guy way off balance.
Hit hard on the ground to short. And a base hit into left field, so they got themselves a one out base run.
And this is where the manager makes his money right there. Nice at bat. Now it's questionable. Pinch runs. Dan, as a pitcher, did it make you a little nervous when a guy had jets on the base pass?
No doubt about it. This is a very difficult spot. You're one hit away from getting right back into this game and tying this game up. You're going to have to really think about putting somebody on first that might be able to score on the ball in the gap.
That one swung through the strike zone that time at 98. 0-1. Well below the knees, laid off on changeup there.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Oh, on the ground to first. Can this be two? There's one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. One hit in the inning, but that gets erased. Eighth inning coming up. Washington leads this one 5-4. He'll do so to start the eighth. Now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Jeremy De La Rosa. He'll start things out for us here in inning number eight. Set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Strike taken as that one catches the outer part of the plate. Set to deliver the 0-1.
I know to the fans that probably looked like something good to hit, but unless you're sitting breaking ball right there, I don't care if it's middle of the plate. That's a tough pitch to pull the trigger on.
Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes.
Hey, the fish ain't biting there on that 0-2 breaking ball, but you got to be careful because this pitcher might throw him another one.
The 1-2. And he can't get out of the way there, so the leadoff man will be aboard to open up the inning.
Yeah, I can hear the crowd murmuring now, wondering if he hit him on purpose. But hey, us pitchers need to be able to throw inside, especially when facing hitters as dangerous as he is. Pretty sure this one just got away from him, and hey, that's part of the game.
Digging in, Starlin Castro. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Ready. Here's the first offering. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. A runner at first with no outs here. This pitch is popped up. Forsythe is there. And that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting, number four.
Ready for another chance? Number four, 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. First pitch coming, here it is. Taken, but that catches the inside part of the plate. Before the 0-1, he'll check on first. One out, one on, in a one-run game. Pitch out. Nothing doing. Now the 1-1 pitch. A ball and two strikes now. Lays off, 2-2 now. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
It's been a rough night at the yard for him. That's how many times he's gone down on strikes in this one. So they've really figured out how to attack this guy.
Into the box, Tyler Nevin, as he takes a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. The 0-1 pitch. That finds the zone, a called strike.
Boy, this is one of those ABs you like to hit the rewind button on. Put himself in a tough spot now, hitting with two strikes.
Ready with the 0-2.
Ball.
Throw over to the bag. Dive, but he's back in there. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Hit high in the air down the right field line. Harper on the run. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. One left for Washington. They hold on to a 5-4 lead. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Sean Doolittle will come on now and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Luis Garcia will also come on now, so he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hole in the order here on that double switch. And Bryce Harper will dig into the plate. Sat down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
No balls and a strike to count. Oh, heading out towards shallow right. Eaton is under it. He's got it one away. Digging in, Reese Hoskins is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. First pitch of the at bat.
Nope.
Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. One out, nobody on. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole.
Hey, you guys know me. Hitting's a process of elimination, and I'm eliminating the changeup this next pitch. I'm on everything else.
High in the air out to center field. De La Rosa is there now, and he has it. Two gone.
The left fielder, number 23, Jay Bruce.
Stepping in, Jake Bruce struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, big time K last time up, and it's been a tough series for him so far. You can tell he's just not seeing the ball off this team. Let's see if he can make an adjustment right here.
He's set, and the pitch. Run at the plate, the 0-1. Swing and a miss, and he's in control, 0-2.
Hey, I notice pitcher's getting ahead right here. He's got the hitter down 0-2, but to this guy in the box, might want to just live on the corners a little bit more. You keep missing down the middle, something's not coming back.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Two out, nobody on. This is with a fastball.
Boy, that's a great take right there. He might have been frozen by that pitch, but it missed by just enough to give him life in this AB.
And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. He struck him out. Third time he's fanned in the game. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. And the deficit holds at 5-4. From the pen to start the ninth inning, as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one, but right now it'll be the catcher, Sean Murphy. First delivery to him on the way. And it's fouled away. Oh and one, here it comes. Got him to go after that one. He's in a quick hole. 0-2.
You got to be paying attention as an offense in a hitter's meeting in this situation. When you got a guy on the mound that you know the bottom can drop out of any pitch he throws, you have to elevate your sights.
Nothing in two count, and the pitch hit in the air down the right field line. This will wind up being a foul ball. The 0-2 once more, and he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
Really good late fight on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just starts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
In now, Luis Garcia. As he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. One run game here in the top of the ninth. Missed low and inside with it, one and one. Left side, but well fouled. The 1-2. In four attempts to this point. Up top, it's 2-0.
Two balls, no strike.
Now the pitch. Bouncer to the left side. With his speed, forget it. It's an infield single.
Boy, when things are good, things are going really good. How about a swinging bunt infield single right there for his third knock at the game, D-Ro?
Yeah, he has to be feeling frisky right now. He's had two great at-bats, and then this one, he's 100% on fire. Getting an infield single for his third knock of the game, that's awesome.
Plate now, Adam Eaton. It's outside, the throw. Well behind the play, that's an easy stolen base.
It was pretty obvious he would likely be on the move with two outs, and I'm sure the defense knew it too. But he has lightning speed and was able to take the bag anyways.
And this one's on the inside corner, one and one. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate. Two out here and a runner at second. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. Set and the 3-1 pitch. Fastball too high, ball four.
Now batting the left fielder, Juan Soto.
Stepping into the box, Juan Soto. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Looking to keep this a one run game, the pitch.
1-0.
Ball one, well below the zone.
Well, he's really in trouble, and it's just getting worse and worse and worse. This guy needs to find the strike zone in the worst way.
The set and the 1-0. 2-0 now.
Got to find a way to execute either a good fastball down the way or flip something off speed for a strike. You cannot miss over the heart of the plate in these situations. The hitter is on high alert.
Two balls and a strike now. Men are on with two men out. Yeah. turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. The 2-2 pitch. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head into their final set of swings. Nats leave a pair. They lead it 5-4. Game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth.
Number 36, Will Harris.
So striding in, Zach Collins, over 3 with an RBI in this one.
The catcher, Zach Collins.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Oh, he pitches a curveball that misses 1-2. Here's the pitch. Ball. Misses. Ball two. Two-two. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location. So a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
To the plate now, Logan Forsythe. He looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. The 0-1 pitch.
Off the plate, ball one.
Bases are empty, one man. That one misses badly. It's ball two. Swing and a ground ball to third. First, and now the Phillies are down to their final out.
The pitcher,
Corey Dickerson will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number 12, Corey Dickerson.
Turns on, but it's wide at first and foul. And he comes in as a player to watch out for, hitting well over 300 on the season. Run at the plate, the 0-1.
1-1.
Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Fielded cleanly. Rowan to first is going to be in time. And the Nationals are back in the win column again. They take game 3 of the series, and the ball game is over.
And he puts a bow on this one to end it. How about his 25th save of the season? He's proven to be a solid dude at the back of the bullpen, and every team needs one of those.
This evening's game comes to an end, 5-4, the final tally. The Nationals jumped ahead in the 7th inning and never gave the lead back. Ryan Harper earns the victory out of the bullpen, his 5th. Will Harris hammers down the save, his 25th of the year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.